the early 1900s, way out west of the divide, young man arrived in Telluride. He was born in Virginia, a lad of just 19, headed west and following a dream. He got a job working a team of oxen there, building that old Keystone Road. Outside in the mountains is where he loved to be, no interest in that mining mother lode. Just 6 short years later, the age of 25, he found the love of his life. Her name was Viola, there's no more need to roam. They married, he knew he'd found his home. Guy Warrick, Guy Warrick, Guy Warrick had finally settled down. He was soon to be a legend and a man with much respect out in that old west mining town. At the age of 35, with 2 daughters and 2 sons, for the job of sheriff he did run. Well, yes, he was elected and started his career, fair-minded, honest, and sincere. He seldom wore a gun, still had outlaws on the run. It's there that the legend had begun. Forming posses, busting thieves, and the murdering SOBs, cleaning up that Colorado town. In 1956, at the age of 64, postman brought a letter to his door. It was from J. Edgar Hoover, director of the FBI, a letter this famous man did write. With your cooperation and much outstanding help, bad criminal, we did apprehend. So thank you, Sherff Warrick, to you my best regards. Your persistence helped bring him in. A dog lover had his faithful bulldog Jigs, a companion who never left his side. Yes, they were together almost all the time. Mr. Jigs even helped him solve a crime. 25 years later and 9 terms he did serve, retirement ended his career. Just 7 years later he died peacefully. Until you're right, he was 73. Sherff Warrick, Guy Warrick, this legend was your destiny. Sherff Warrick, Guy Warrick, not a better man anyone could be. Sherff Warrick, Guy Warrick, this legend was your destiny. Sherff Warrick, Guy Warrick, not a better man anyone could be. No better man anyone could be. I said not a better man.